having to import your intro, outro, social media logo threads, YouTube end screens, and whatever have you that you always use when you're editing for YouTube, each and every single time when you're starting a new project, can be very time consuming over the long run. But that is over by now. I'm gonna show you a technique where everything is already inside the project, and not only that, it is already laid out on the timeline perfectly. Are you ready? The first thing I want you to do is fire up DaVinci Resolve and then create a new project. Call this project template and then hit create. Then what I want you to do is just import every stuff that you always use when you're editing for YouTube. For example, let's create a folder and call this intro. And by the way, you don't have to follow along with my folder structure. This is just a structure that I always use to stay organized. You can just dump everything into the master bin if that's how you're editing. Then what I want you to do is go through the project settings and make sure that everything is set up the way you want it to be. I'm not gonna cover that because I already made a dedicated video to this topic. Then the next step is just dump everything that you always use on your timeline, something like that. And whenever you load up your project, you want it to look like this. So you basically have your intro at the beginning, then you have your lower thirds here, and maybe a subscribe reminder on here, and then you have your outro and end screen at the end. What I want you to do now is hit Control and S to save the project, then hit Control and Q to shut down DaVinci Resolve. And you'll see why in a second. Then what I want you to do is reopen DaVinci Resolve. Then you'll see your template project. First of all, I want you to right click on that and make sure dynamic project switching is on. But then I want you to open this, but not regularly open. I want you to open this in read-only mode. This will load up the project. And as you can see, nothing has changed, right? Then what I want to do, let's say I'm in here. And when this is loaded up, it should say read-only at the top. And if you see that, you're off to a great start, because right now I can go to my screen recording and I want to import a screen recording, so I can do that. Then I import in my screen recording, then into my audio folder. Of course, I'm gonna import my audio. Boom. And what I'm gonna be doing now is I'm gonna drop everything onto the timeline just like so. And then I can see, oh, okay, my outro is a little bit too early. So let's bring this over here. Then I'm gonna go to my screen recording, something like that. And right now I have everything set up perfectly. I can bring my intro back here. I can make, you know, my cuts, can edit the whole project. After you finish that, you can then render it out. And I personally like to save my project, so I'm gonna hit Control and S, and it will ask you to save the current project as template copy. And then you're just gonna give your project a name, call this YouTube template, and then hit save. Then I want you to hit Control and Q once again to shut DaVinci Resolve down, reopen this. Then of course you want to navigate to your template folder. We still have our template here, and we have the YouTube template that we just created. So right click on that, open in read only mode. And right now you might remember I've imported media to that. But if I'm gonna go to my screen recording, nothing's in here. And I don't have an audio folder because I just recently edited this into our other project, and we can change projects in here. If we go to this one right here, YouTube template, you can see that this is the YouTube template right now, and everything is perfectly set up the way we left it. But if I'm gonna switch over to the template, everything is stored in here. Just to wrap things up real quick, the whole point of this video is create a new project, call that project template. Then I want you to either you'll be organized like me and create a bunch of folders and import all your media into that. Just keep in mind, just import the media that you always use for each and every YouTube project. Then dump everything to the timeline, reorganize the stuff on your timeline, control save, and then Control Q to quit DaVinci Resolve, then reload DaVinci Resolve, right click, open in read only mode, and then do your edit from there. So that's a wrap. I really hope that you learned something new, and I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If so, please consider leaving a like, that would mean a ton to me. But anyways, hope you're having a great day. See you in the next one. Bye.